This is a production of PBS 39.
Finally tonight, Mother Teresa once said, if you can't feed 100 people, then just feed one. Well, Meals on Wheels of Northampton County feeds over 700 people each and every day, with help from scores of wonderful volunteers, including some very special people at Prudential Patt White Realtors in Easton. Grover Silcox tagged along with them one day and brings us this report.
Like most realtors, the associates at Prudential Patt White in Easton use their wheels to serve clients looking for homes. But one day a month, they use those same wheels to help feed people who are homebound or who might otherwise go hungry.
The second Thursday of each month, our sales partners get together and deliver Meals on Wheels.
These volunteers serve mostly seniors and disabled folks who live in and around Palmer Township.
Lehigh Valley Association of Realtors does promote volunteerism as well, Prudential Patt White, and it's just our way of giving back.
On this particular day, two of the firm's associates, Eunice Nicosanti and Randy Decker, go as a team to Meals on Wheels headquarters in Bethlehem to pick up that day's packaged meals.
We meet here at Meals on Wheels about 10:30 in the morning.
Randy and Eunice converge with dozens of other volunteers at the center where 1,500 meals are prepared and packaged each morning.
Most of our volunteers are retired. They're wonderful. We have kids from the school system who come in the summertime and volunteer. We have single moms who bring their children with them.
And of course, there are volunteers such as Randy and Eunice who come from companies that support volunteerism.
It's a way of volunteering and doing something good for people that doesn't take a major part of your life. Eunice and myself start about 10:30 in the morning delivering our meals, and we're done in about 2 hours.
It's a very small give back to the community.
It may seem small, but it's a very big service.
All of our food is purchased through local vendors in the area, and our food is prepared right on site.
Typically, each client receives two meals, a hot meal for lunch and a cold one for dinner.
All of our meals have to have, they have to meet state standards. They have to have a certain amount of fat, a certain amount of protein. They're all low salt, they're all low fat, a certain amount of carbohydrates.
They also prepare meals especially for restricted or special diets. There are lots of options worked out by Meals on Wheels caseworkers.
Because the case manager will always come out and make a home visit with you prior to going on to meals.
Today, Randy and Eunice make two stops.
Not every person on a route is in total need of food or will starve without us, but they are dependent upon us to bring them food, maybe because they're handicapped, they have some type of disability.
We deliver meals and we also do a daily check of our clients to make sure they're okay.
The volunteers do more than make deliveries. They also make friends. Clients connect with Meals on Wheels in a variety of ways, through hospitals, home care professionals, or sometimes by simply calling Meals on Wheels themselves.
I get a visiting nurse coming here, and she mentioned about it.
Now that Peggy got her meals, it's off to the next client.
Randy, when you were away, I made sure that I didn't miss the older gentleman that we're stopping at next, because he really, really doesn't have anything in the house. You can tell his wife had passed away, and he waits for us to get his meals.
79-year-old Lewis looks forward each and every day to his visitors and their Meals on Wheels.
Everybody home with the lights and they're out.
That's good. All right.
The volunteers draw Lewis out to share something about himself with the camera crew.
I used to run a restaurant years ago, way back in the 60s.
As Lewis dives into the hot platter, the volunteers go to their regular jobs, satisfied that their deliveries have made a real difference for people in need.
Realtors make their living selling homes and being involved with homes, and to whom much is given, much is required.
There's a number of people that I'm well aware of the fact that if we don't deliver the meals, they really won't eat that day.
It's almost instant gratification when you go out there and you deliver a meal. you're giving a meal to someone who is extremely appreciative.
And so, Executive Director Joanne Nienau, her staff, and their vitally important legion of volunteers keep Meals on Wheels rolling, even as the older population increases and funding gets tougher to come by. In spite of these challenges, however, they are committed to making sure that every member of the community who needs a meal gets one.
As long as Meals on Wheels needs us, we will definitely be there to help.
For Tempo, I'm Grover Silcox reporting.